again. Okay, we're here with Seth from the Electronic Frontier Foundation, and you're giving out flyers and stickers today at the SOPA protest here at the Civic Center in San Francisco. What brought you down here today?
Well, I heard from my coworkers that EFF was supporting this protest. I've just been out of town for a week and I missed a lot of the activist activity that's been going on around SOPA and PIPA, so I wanted to come out and get involved and show some support on behalf of EFF.
Can you tell us, our viewers, a little bit about the EFF?
Sure, EFF is a nonprofit, member-supported organization here in San Francisco. We fight for civil liberties and civil rights on the internet.
And how old is your organization?
EFF is now 21 years old, so the oldest internet freedom organization.
So you guys have been in the business here for a long time. Would you say that in the current times is probably the most challenging times for the internet, given that SOPA and PIPA laws are being proposed?
The internet's been through a lot of threats and will probably continue to go through a lot of threats. We think that the threat from SOPA and PIPA is among the larger threats that internet freedom has faced in the last couple of years.
And why is that?
SOPA and PIPA threaten to create the equivalent of a national firewall, like we've seen in some other countries, where the government orders internet service providers to block particular sites and completely block access to them. That's something that people are familiar with from China and Iran, but something that actually the United States has never had in the history of the internet.
So we could actually provide Iran and China real competition in internet censorship.
Sure, a lot of people have talked about the idea that enacting legislation like this would help give legitimacy to internet blocking efforts in other countries, because governments of other countries have said repeatedly, well, blocking sites on the internet is normal. Every country does that. Mm-hmm. You know, that's just a natural thing to do. But in fact, the United States has never done that. The United States has never ordered internet service providers to block websites.
Mm-hmm. So we're kind of behind the times. We need to get with it.
We need to catch up, perhaps, to other countries that have national firewalls and block internet sites.
Yeah, because, I mean, we're falling. I mean, there's basically a repression gap, right? I mean, we're really falling behind here. I mean, countries like China are way ahead of us. I mean, don't you think that
they have a multiple years head start?
They do, yeah. And what can we do to catch up? Maybe SOPA and PIPA might be a first good step.
Sure, then we can create a legal framework for blocking websites, for ordering ISPs to pretend that sites don't exist, mm-hmm. to return false and misleading error messages about the non-existence of sites that are really still up.
That sounds wonderful. How large is your organization here in San Francisco? I mean, seriously now.
EFF is about 40 people.
Okay. And do you have offices in other parts of the United States, or are you all here?
We have one person in Washington, D.C., but everyone else is here in San Francisco at our headquarters.
And you guys are funded all through donations?
Yeah, so we're a nonprofit organization.
And if I wanted to donate to the EFF, how would I go about doing that?
If you went to our website at EFF.org, you would find lots of information about donating to support our work.
Seth, we really appreciate your time. Thank you very much.
Thanks for coming out here.
Right now. Got a couple minutes?
Real quick, yeah.
Okay. So, MC Hammer is the name you go by, I guess.
Okay.
Sorry.
Let's not waste no time now. Come on, man.
But anyway, so the question was, question I have, you're a content provider, and you're here to support SOPA. As a content provider, I mean, you don't have any concerns about protecting your copyright, so why you're here?
Well, that would be ignorant. Of course I have concerns about protecting copyrights, but that's the surface of the bill. If you drill down at the very second and treasury level of the bill, you'll see that it's about control. It's about putting in legislation and initiatives that would stifle creativity, that would stifle innovation. So if you just want to protect copyrights, then come up with the terminology and the language necessary for that, but don't use a bill that is really about other things, that is really about monetization at a higher level, shifting control of the internet away from innovation and into the hands of government. So that's what this is really all about. It's not mm-hmm. about just protecting movies and music and content. Of course, to a certain extent, we all agree that, that there should be protection, but we don't agree that it should be government legislation that also stifles innovation. And in a down economy, we have a growth engine here in tech, and we don't want to stifle that. We want to continue to create jobs, and we want to continue to innovate.
So is this is the SOPA only concerns the tech industry, or is that also, you know, the average Joe citizen in the Midwest? I mean, should they also be concerned, and why?
The average Joe citizen should be concerned, because if this is passed, average Joe can receive a lawsuit in the mail, like many of you've seen in the last few years, that say that the average Joe now is liable for hundreds of thousands and millions of dollars for infringing on a copyright rather without due process. So it could be very... It could be very to the detriment of the average Joe if he doesn't understand what's going on with SOPA.
Are there other artists that are lining up to the opposition of SOPA that you know of?
I'm not aware of what current artists are doing or not, but I've never been a person who needs to follow. I'm in reading, I'm in the comprehension, and I'm into the fine details, and I see things out for myself. So I don't need necessarily a whole crowd for me to understand what I'm dealing with. But
I was just curious if you knew
to any other artists who are on board.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Have you talked to any other artists?
Through platforms, mm-hmm. through social media. Many artists see what's going on, but again, to each his own.
Got it. Well, thank you very much for your time.
Appreciate it.